I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. How are you, my dear viewer? I hope the Lord has been keeping you well and you are fine. Today is day 49 of our 100 days of prayer. And today I'd like to bring your attention to the focus of prayer. And our topic today is the compassion of Jesus Christ. Our Bible verse for today comes from the book of Psalms 116, verse 5. And before we continue, I would like request you to humble yourself so that we can pray. Shall we pray? Our kind and loving Master in heaven, we come before thy throne of grace this day to thank you and to glorify your name, for you have been so good unto us. Your faithfulness is so abundant, and we can't take that for granted. We want to thank you. This day, 49 of our 100 days of prayer, while the world church is crying unto thee and bringing their prayers and supplication to you, we want also to come before thy throne of grace, and we are requesting you that may you hear our prayers. And as we start off by hearing from your throne through your word, we pray that may your holy presence abide with us. In Christ Jesus we have prayed and given thanks. Amen. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 116, I'll read from the New King James Version, and that is verse 5, 116 verse 5. The Bible says that gracious is the Lord and righteous, yes, our God is merciful. The Bible is very clear here, and as you can see, the Bible says that gracious is the Lord and the Lord is merciful. Have you ever imagined of those moments in school that you had with some teachers whom you liked and some others you didn't like? For instance, there are some subjects that most of us did not like, not because the subjects were hard or the subjects were bad, but it is because the attitude that we had towards our teacher, it's what determined how we liked the subjects. And this is the same even in our lives. Sometimes we are faced with some people, or some people come into our life when we don't like to associate with them. Sometimes there are teachers who are very dear to us, and when those subjects came, we were happy and we enjoyed even being in those classes. And some teachers we couldn't even like to be in their companion. This is the same way that the disciples of Christ, or some people, felt when they came to Jesus. When they were in his presence, they felt that they were moved, and they had someone who loved them. The Pharisees had only scorn and condemnation for them, but Christ greeted them as children of God, estranged indeed from the Father's house, but not forgotten by the Father's heart. And their very misery and sin made them only the more the object of his compassion. Some teachers were very welcoming. When we went to ask for, when you go to ask questions, they did not condemn you. They showed you, or they explained in love. But others, when you went to ask them, it is like you are bothering them. And that's how the Pharisees were. When the Pharisees were dealing with people, they were not dealing with them in kind heart. But when Jesus came, he was dealing with people in kindness, and people loved them. The Father, they had wandered from him. When people went away from Jesus, they felt there is something they are missing. The more earnest they were longing, and the greater the sacrifice for their rescue. They wanted to be closer to him. They wanted to associate with him. Today, God's grace to us is a direct result of his great compassion towards all who suffer under sin and its consequences. Realizing his compassion towards you as revealed in Jesus, what is hindering you to come to him? Like the teachers, we couldn't go to them because they were rebuking. But Jesus was welcoming. Jesus loved his people. And even today, he loves us. What is hindering us from going to him? Because even if we are sinners, he is welcoming us. Let us surrender
to him. Let us go to him. Jesus understands your situation. He understands your burdens. He understands your struggles and temptations. He is more than willing to help. He'll forgive, uplift, and strengthen you. Will you let his love, grace, and compassion melt any resistance of indifference you might be feeling towards him today? Let us welcome him in our hearts. My prayer today is that you allow Jesus come in your heart, that you allow him to be closer to you. Remember the verse that we read today, the verse that came from the book of Psalms 116 verse 5. The Bible is very clear. The Bible says that the Lord is gracious and righteous. Our God is full of compassion. That is God, is the God that I'm calling you today. That even as we continue to plead for our brother, as we continue to intercede for them, that we will draw closer and closer to Jesus. Remember, COVID-19, the situation that we are having today, it's not something to live forever. It is something that is coming. It's a wave that is coming and going. But our relationship with Christ will depend the way we will view the situation. Let us join hands with the least Adventists and Christians who are realizing that it is very important to be closer, and it is even more comfortable and to be near God and to live in under his wings. May God bless you today, and may God be with you. And as we continue even struggling in life, let us not forget there is a friend that we have, and God is very closer to us. Today, I want to invite you in our prayer session. I know that you have a prayer request that you have. I know that you have a burden in your heart, and you would like to submit it to the Lord. I would like to recommend this, that go to the Lord in prayer. Join me in prayer. As I intercede for you, I want you also to believe that God is able to do marvelous thing, a burden thing that no one can be able to do. Anything is possible. Everything is possible through Christ who strengthens us. When we believe in him, I know and I have faith that he will answer our prayers. Shall we join in prayer at this moment? Our kind and loving Master, we thank you for the word that has come from your scriptures. You have instructed us that, Father, you love us, and we believe in that. You died for us, and even today you are the one who is sustaining us. We ask that may your Holy Spirit abide with us today, and as we continue to plead with you and to intercede for those who are suffering, Father, we pray that may you hear our prayers. Around the world, there are people, the saints are crying unto you daily, morning, evening, noon, every time we are pleading with you, that you come and sort the situation that we are in. We pray that, Jehovah, may you come in for us, and may we see your hand in our lives. I want to commit my dear viewer into the able throne. May you remember him or her. Father, there are the prayer requests that she has or he has in the heart. Father, I pray that may you answer those prayers according to your riches in glory. There are those who are suffering because of this pandemic, the COVID-19. Father, may you visit them in a special way. Be with the physicians who are taking care of the patients. Be with the government who are working day and night to see that they have curbed the spread of this disease. And Father, help us so that, Father, we will take the precautions that we are being given, so that, Jehovah, we will be happy, and at the end of it all, we will come out of these victorious. Thank you, because you are faithful and you will continue to be with us. And even as we look forward for tomorrow to hear from thee and to also submit our prayers to thee, may your name be glorified. It is in Christ Jesus we have prayed and given thanks. Amen. Thank you. May God bless you, and have a wonderful time.